This is Dr. Arthur Frost speaking. We are on day number 13 of our declaration and prophetic warfare over our nation in Jesus' name. Man, I'm telling you, I'm enjoying this. This is so exciting to see the prophetic words as we're going. We are on day number 13 already. You can see by the words that have come through already. It's a wonderful, wonderful time for South Africa. I want to just tell you, it's awesome to be a South African. It's awesome to be alive. It's awesome to be part of this because I know God is busy with something. All right, let's get into our prophetic word for this morning. All right, let's go. It's a prophecy by Jennifer LeClaire. It was in August 2020. And this is what the word says. I heard the Lord saying over South Africa, I'm calling you to pull you from your revival heritage. I'm calling you to pray the prayer of the pioneers. If you will cultivate in your heart a passion for souls and pray for the harvest, I will rain down on you. I will rend the heavens and come down to you. South Africa will be awakened when the intercessors are fully awake and when the evangelists are prepared to reap the harvest. Pray then to the Lord of the harvest that he will ready laborers to reap after intercession is sown. Pray without ceasing until you see my will come to pass. For many revivals will break out in Africa, but South Africa is the tipping point to the awakening of a continent. All right, South Africa is the tipping point and the awakening to a continent. All right, the question is, who will pray? Right, let's go through the points and we'll discuss them. All right, we need a pull from your revival heritage. In other words, there have been people in our nation that know how to bring revival. People that have brought revival into the continent before. People that have come from South Africa and moved through the nations. I want to tell you right now, there is a revival heritage built into South Africa. There is something about South Africans that we are not like every other nation. There is a pioneering thing. We will go in where it's tough. We will do what we need to do. I'm telling you right now, there is a stickability, there is a creativity, and there is a genuine force that is built inside of South Africa. And I want to tell you right now, from a spiritual point of view, the Bible is very clear that people have been gifted with certain tasks. One of the tasks of South Africa is for a revival. All right, we have a revival anointing, and we can actually go and do things for God. And God is going to say, out of the heritage, out of the years gone past, we have received something that we can continue with, that there is a heritage of revival across this nation, and we can go out and do this in the name of Jesus. All right, pray for the prayer, pray the prayer of pioneers. What does that mean? Well, it means a pioneer is where there's no roadmap. We are not doing this the same as everybody else. We are not sitting down and saying, well, this is the road to go. If you go and look at the pioneers who walked through Africa, there was no freeway, there was nothing to follow. They had to hear God's voice on the trot and say, God, we are trusting you for a supernatural move of your spirit in our nation. We are trusting you to lead us into the next step. Show us where to go. Show us what to do. That is a prayer of a pioneer. That we're saying, God, we are relying on you. We are not copying the old school. We are not copying the old ways. We are asking you, what do you want us to do next? And as we take that approach, I want to tell you right now, God is going to give us the strategy for this season. Every season, every group, every generation has a different strategy. I want to tell you right now, God is busy stirring in our nation. And as we pray this kind of prayer, we are going to see the power of God be made manifest in our nation. All right, we need to cultivate a passion for souls and the harvest. We need to sit down and realize that this is all about souls. A lot of the church are still in the state where it's all about me. You know, it's about my comfort zone and how did COVID affect me and how did the politics affect me or the economic situation affect me. That is so short term. All right, we are looking at something that is eternity. If you go and change your focus and say, God, let me focus on souls. Let me focus on getting somebody out of hell and into heaven. And Lord, I thank you that you're going to help me so that every single person gets into heaven and is not in hell and is not in a place where they are going to lose their salvation and end up in something that was created for Satan and never for man. Man was never created to go to hell. All right, God created man to have dominion over this earth and to have fun. All right, and be under His guidance and blessing, not under a demonic influence. So right now, we need to change our focus, church. We need to change our focus onto souls and say, God, You have left us on this earth. Remember, if you are born again, you are entitled to go to heaven. So why are you still here? Why are you still on this earth? You are here for a purpose and a reason, and that ultimately is to get people saved. So we need to start focusing and saying, God, what are we going to do to get people out of hell and get them into heaven? Now, there's going to be two things that are going to come. God says the intercessors are going to stand up. I want to just say, and I want to commend all of the intercessors in South Africa. Man, I have never seen such a strong army standing up across this nation. Man, the minute we call, they climb out from everywhere and they start calling on God. Let me tell you something. Our nation is already turning back to prayer. There is a major move already starting to happen. Already, remember that this word was given in 2020. I'm telling you now, intercessors are praying. Intercessors are up right through the night. I know because I'm connected with a lot of them. I want to tell you right now, there are literally networks that pray 24/7 around this nation, for our nation. And so the intercessors are coming into force. They are starting to call on God like never before. It's not that they never prayed. They carried this nation for many years. But I'm just saying, as the body of Christ, every town, every little dorpie, there's people praying and seeking God like never before. And it's not because of a crisis, but it's because of a stir that's come on the hearts. And they're starting to stir up and say, God, we need You. We are calling on You to do something in our nation. And I want to tell you right now that they are waking up. The intercessors in this nation are waking up. And we need to declare that there are more intercessors. And then the next thing that's going to come is that the evangelists are going to come. We need to start praying and training evangelists. People, how to lead people to the Lord. We need to let people know how to lead them to the Lord, how to get them out of hell, how to get them to the place that God has for them. And God says that this is going to be a very different way, and it's not going to be the normal way. So we need to trust God. What is the key for this season? How do we train evangelists? How do we identify men and women who are called to go out and go and demonstrate signs and wonders and lead people to the Lord? We need to start preparing for this harvest. We need to get ready. If God says this is coming, we need to prepare. Nobody goes into the battle and starts getting trained in the middle of the battle. You can't wait for a revival to break out and then try and train some people. We need to say to God, God, help us to start praying over the laborers. Start identifying the right men and women so that they are ready for this when it comes. Next point, pray without ceasing. All right, I believe that we are busy with that. I believe that prayer is going up, not just within intercessors, but across this nation. I have never ever experienced the nation praying as much as we are right now. But I'm telling you right now, we can increase that. We can increase that. The faster we pray, the more we pray, the more people we pray. I want to tell you right now, the faster and the quicker the time comes, because the power of God starts moving. And then lastly, South Africa is the tipping point of this continent. I want to tell you right now, God has said it from the start. South Africa is the key, the gateway into the continent. Everything is going to be birthed through South Africa. There is a reason why God has chosen South Africa. And from the southern tip, every prophetic word for as many years back, as long as I've been saved, has always identified the starting point is South Africa. Always starting in the southern tip of South Africa. So I'll tell you what, there is something exciting happening, something exciting that's going to take place. I just find this interesting. You know, people, if they say about the southern tip of Africa, they always take Cape Town as the southern tip. All right, what is interesting is Port Elizabeth is the southern tip of Africa. So southern, we have the southern tip, Cape Agulhas, the lowest point of Africa, but the closest city, the most southern city, is Port Elizabeth. Port Elizabeth is actually lower than Cape Town. And so God is busy with something in our continent. God is going to do something through our nation. And I want you to know that we need to be part of this in Jesus' name. So let's declare this. Lord, we thank You that we can declare that we have a revival heritage, and we call that on to our nation and onto each one of us. Lord, we thank You and we declare that we are going to be prayer warriors, and we will pray the prayer of the pioneers. Lord, that we will not follow our old structure, but God, we will know what what you want for this season in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray right now and declare that we will be passionate for souls. Lord, that we will be focused on getting people out of hell in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you right now. We declare that the intercessors will stand solid and strong across this nation like we've never seen before, in every single town, in every city, in every little dorpie, in Jesus' name. Lord, I thank you that prayer will be over this nation. We declare prayer the center pillar of this nation in Jesus' name, the foundation of everything, in the mighty name of Jesus. And God, I thank you that we can declare that South Africa is the tipping point of this continent, and that we will see it happen in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said amen and amen. All right, so we're going to just take communion right now. And as we take communion, I want us just to celebrate the fact that Jesus Christ has paid the price. Every one of these prophetic words, every one of these promises have come just because Jesus has paid the price, and he has got a plan and a purpose for us in Jesus' name. All right? On the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and broke it, and he said, "This is my body that was broken for you, take in remembrance of me." He took the cup and he said that, "This is my blood that was shed for you, take in remembrance of me." The body of Christ was broken for your physical and emotional healing. The blood of Jesus was shed for your salvation, protection, and provision. So right now, as we take of these elements, let us celebrate what Jesus Christ has done for us. Let us celebrate the fact that he has paid the price, and that he has chosen South Africa to do a work in Jesus' name. Lord, we come before you. We ask you please to forgive us of any wrongdoing, any wrong thought, action, motive, intention. Lord, I ask you right now that you're going to move by your Spirit in a mighty way in Jesus' name. And Lord, right now, I thank you that we stand pure before you. But Lord, I thank you for the price that was paid. I thank you, Lord, for the promises that were made over South Africa. And I thank you, Lord, that we could fight with them in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord, that as we take of the elements, Lord, that your power will move in South Africa, that people will get saved, that evangelists will rise up, Lord, that intercessors will rise up, that the church will wake up in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I pray that you'll wake me up as I take of these elements and recognize what you have done for me in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said amen and amen. Let's partake together. Thank you. Lord, right now in the mighty name of Jesus, I seal every single word that has gone out today. Lord, I thank you for the declaration that men and women will be saved in our nation. Lord, I thank you for the declaration that evangelists will rise up, that intercessors will rise up. Lord, I thank you for your blessing over our nation in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen and amen.